Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. If you drive a manual car, there are two primary components that control your clutch pedal, and that is the clutch master cylinder and the clutch slave cylinder. If you end up with a problem in your manual vehicle where you're having a hard time getting the clutch to engage or disengage, or your pedal is feeling very weak, you're not able to fully press it down to be able to actually change gears or get the car into gear, or if your clutch pedal is actually getting stuck to the floor and not returning to where it should be, it's likely that you have an issue with your clutch master or slave cylinder. So in this video today, we're gonna go ahead and talk a little bit about the master cylinder, the slave cylinder, how the two work together, and then I'll talk about signs and symptoms of a bad master and slave cylinder and provide you with a little bit of diagnostic help on how to determine whether the issue that you're having with your clutch pedal is because of the master cylinder or because of the slave cylinder. Let's go ahead and jump into how these components work. The master cylinder uses brake fluid to create hydraulic pressure. The master cylinder is what's attached to your clutch pedal. So when you press your clutch pedal down, what that does is that builds up hydraulic pressure inside the master cylinder. And then the master cylinder is attached via a hydraulic line to the slave cylinder. The slave cylinder is usually located a bit closer to the transmission, and the slave cylinder is what actually controls the clutch fork for you to be able to shift between gears and engage and disengage the clutch. And so when you press your foot down on the pedal, we build up pressure in the master cylinder. We then send that pressure to the slave cylinder, which then works the transmission or the clutch fork so that you can shift. So both of these components are directly related to your clutch pedal and to your transmission with respect to your ability to get into gear, to shift between gears, and to get out of gear. So if you have a problem with any of those things, it's gonna be one of these two components. However, there are some similarities between symptoms of failure for both of these components. So let's go ahead and talk about what you might experience when the clutch master cylinder fails versus when the clutch slave cylinder fails. A sign that your master cylinder is going bad is gonna be having a soft or spongy clutch. If your clutch pedal is kind of just wiggling there and it doesn't take a whole lot of pressure to push it in or to release it, that is a good sign that your master cylinder is what's bad. And that's because your master cylinder is what's directly connected to the clutch pedal, and you pushing down the clutch is what builds up that hydraulic pressure. And so when it's really easy to press down, that means you're not building any hydraulic pressure, which means you have an issue with your master cylinder. In addition to that, you could have the clutch pedal sticking to the floor. You could notice that it's very difficult to get in or out of gear, or as you shift, you're grinding in between gears. And you could notice that you have fluid leaks inside your vehicle right underneath where the clutch pedal is located. So those four things are the primary signs and symptoms of a bad master cylinder. So now, with respect to the slave cylinder, let's go ahead and talk about signs and symptoms there. The first thing to look for is going to be brake fluid leaks coming from the slave cylinder, which is going to be located underneath the vehicle or somewhere in the engine bay, a little bit closer to the transmission. In addition to that, we could also get the clutch pedal sticking to the floor, and we could also have issues with the gears grinding, getting in and out of gear, and engaging and disengaging the clutch. You can have lots of what's called clutch pedal travel. If you drive a manual vehicle, you generally have a pretty good feel of at what point the clutch actually starts to engage. So if you feel that point is changing and it's getting, you know, further and further away, meaning, you know, you have to depress the pedal even further and then the clutch starts catching earlier on, that's called clutch pedal travel. And that's a good sign that you're having an issue with your slave cylinder. And then of course you can have issues getting in and out of gear, which is similar to an issue with the master cylinder. Looking at these signs and symptoms here, there's some pretty similar overlap between the two. If your clutch pedal sticks to the floor or you have trouble shifting in and out of gears, then that can be a symptom of either a bad slave cylinder or a bad master cylinder. So when it comes to determining which one it is, the best thing to look for is really going to be the feel of the clutch. If that's just a really soft pedal, it's spongy, it's very easy to press in, that's going to be the master cylinder because that's what's directly connected to the clutch pedal. Now, if your clutch pedal feels normal, but has the same amount of force to push it in and release it, then your master cylinder isn't going to be the problem because that means that you're properly building up all of the hydraulic pressure pressure that you need within the master cylinder. So from there, your issue is gonna be with the slave cylinder. So if your clutch pedal feels totally fine, but it still sticks to the floor, you still have issues getting in and out of gear, then the slave cylinder is gonna be the problem. With that delineation, let's go ahead and talk about some diagnostic steps here. There really isn't a whole lot to it, but one of the things that I didn't mention earlier on is that a common cause of clutch-related issues can be just a lack of fluids. So this system operates based off of hydraulic fluid. And when I say hydraulic fluid, pretty much most vehicles use brake fluid to do it. However, there is a separate reservoir for the master cylinder for the clutch. And so you'll want to figure out where that reservoir is and make sure that there's enough brake fluid in there. If there's not enough brake fluid, go ahead and fill it up and see if that fixes your issue. However, if you are low on fluid in there, that could also mean that you are leaking fluid somewhere. So the first step is just to check, make sure you have enough fluid. If you don't, fill up the fluid and see if that's your issue. If that's not the issue, if the fluid all checks out, it's either full or you put more in there, and you're still having problems, then you have a problem with either your master cylinder or your slave cylinder. So from a diagnostic step, it's really check whether there's fluid in there. If there is fluid in there, you're gonna have to replace one of these components. The one other caveat is air can get into the system and cause issues. However, if you haven't replaced one of these components recently, then there would be no reason for air to get into the system unless there's a leak coming from the master or the slave cylinder. So determining which one you're gonna wanna replace, again, is gonna come down to the feel of the clutch. If the clutch is weak, it's very soft, it's your master cylinder. The clutch feels great, you're just still having trouble getting into gear, then the issue is going to be with your slave cylinder. Now, master cylinders and slave cylinders usually aren't too expensive. The one problem is that they're not located in the same area of the car, so to speak. The master cylinder is located inside the vehicle, right attached to your clutch pedal, and then the slave cylinder is going to be located on the outside somewhere in the engine bay closer to the transmission. So it's not necessarily the easiest to just replace both at the same time, but master cylinders and slave cylinders aren't that expensive, and so it doesn't hurt to just go ahead and replace both of them, especially if you're not sure which one's causing the issue. These components do tend to fail separately. The caveat here is that, of course, the master cylinder failing can cause the slave cylinder to fail. The slave cylinder to fail can cause the master cylinder. So one can lead to failure of the other, and that's why I say, if you have the time to do the DIY, then it's good to just go ahead and do both of them. Anyways, guys, that covers it on clutch master cylinders and slave cylinders. These are slightly complicated components to understand what one versus the other does, but it generally is pretty easy to tell when your issue's with the master or with the slave just based off of the feel of the clutch pedal. So go ahead and use the feel of the clutch pedal to determine which one's your problem and go ahead and get that replaced. I hope this video was helpful. I hope it helped you solve any issues that you're having with your clutch on your manual vehicle. If you guys appreciate this content, please click the like button, subscribe to our channel, and stay tuned for future content.